All right, welcome back to WallyWorkshop.com. It's maintenance season. It's the middle of the summer here. Mike looks like he's been working real hard and sweating, but he actually just got done washing the ketchup off his shirt from spilling hot dog juice all over himself.
Nice guy.
But anyways, what we're doing today is we're going to change the gear lube on the 300 Verado and also on the 99 Pro Kicker, and we'll show you that every step of the way through that right now. Mike will take you through it.
All right, the first thing you're going to do with a Verado motor, the drain plug is down behind the procker, so you're going to remove it. It's a good idea to remove your prop, you know, 3, 4, 5 times a year, just to check for fishing line back there by your seal. A little bit of a preventative maintenance there can save you a lot of money in the long run. All right, you slide the prop off like that, and let's get a visual on the drain plug. The drain plug is right there. This is a Verado motor, or any outboard motor has got to be in the vertical position, so your plate right here is level, so everything drains out. So before I lower it down, I'm going to loosen this to make my job a little bit easier than working down on the ground. Okay, the drain plug is here. You need something to vent it with. And here's the vent hole right here. Don't remove that until you remove this, and remove the vent very slowly because it'll come out too fast and maybe spill over your floor. Also, there's a little seal washer right here. Make sure you don't lose that. Put it right back on there, put it someplace safe. See, it's hardly coming out here right now. I'll go over here and open the vent and it should come out faster. Okay, we have our drain plug open. Now we're gonna loosen our vent. It should come out a little bit faster now. It's always a good idea to look at the color of your lube that comes out and inspect it a little bit. Kind of put it on your screwdriver like that. If it's a grayish color, that means there's water in there. So what you need to do probably is maybe take it to your dealer. You have to check your inner seal, maybe a piece of fishing line got in here. But this oil looks really good. So we're just gonna go ahead and add new oil after it drips here for, I don't know, about a half hour or so.
All right, we've let the gear lube drain out of the Verado here for about 20 minutes to a half hour or so. There's a couple ways you can go about adding the new gear lube. You can either get the quart bottles and get that pump that you just kind of hand pump, which works great, or you can use something like this. It's a pressurized, almost like a deck spray. It's from Easy Lube. We had gotten these in our AIM tournaments last year. They were one of our sponsors, and the thing works great. You can put a ton of gear lube in here. It'll last you all season long for both our rigs, both our motors. So it's kind of simple. Pump it up, put it up in the drain hole, and when we see the oil coming out of the vent up top, Michael, tell me when to shut it off, and he'll put the vent plug back in, and that'll keep that from draining out the bottom. We'll just cap that off, we'll be done.
And make sure you have this washer on here, because it's a lot of times it'll stick up in there and it'll fall when you don't know it, and you just put the steel plug in there and it's gonna leak. You're gonna cause more problems than it's worth, so you need that washer.
The gear lube we're putting in is a high performance mercury gear lube recommended by Mercury, so that's the stuff you want to put in these Verados. Are you ready?
Yeah. A couple more. Yeah. Yeah.
Cool. All right, we pumped the oil up through the gear case and out the vent. You saw Mike cap it off there. Now, as I'm just kind of holding the end here in place so it doesn't leak out. But like Mike said, make sure that washer is on the screw that you're going to put back in the oil drain. If the washer looks damaged, get to your dealer, get a new one, and replace it. This one looks good, so we'll just get this on there. A little oil is probably going to run out, but not much because that vent screw is back on. So here we go. Good and snug. We should be good to go. That's pretty simple stuff. You can do this with some pretty reasonable parts. You don't have to have the Easy Lube. You can get the hand pumps, but man, that thing sure makes it nice. Next, we're gonna just slide over and do the 9.9 Pro Kicker.
Okay, we're done with our Verado there. We're gonna move on to our 9.9 Pro Kicker. This is a four-stroke motor. There's a vent hole here, and there's also a wash, so make sure you take the right plug out. Read it, you can see it very well here. And right here is our drain hole. So we're gonna take our drain hole, plug out first, and then the vent hole.
All right, we went ahead, we changed the gear lube on both the Verado and the 9.9 Pro Kicker. It's all done. We won't have to worry about this for the rest of the season. We're at about 80 hours on both of our boats. So it's probably a good time to change it.
You know, like Scott said, we're halfway through the season. It's a break-in period for both motors. You know, for the little bit of money that it costs you in oil, it's a good procedure to do that during break-in. But typically, 100 hours or in fall time to make sure there's no water in your lower units, go ahead and change it then. But otherwise everything went well here. We inspected the oil, it was all good looking oil, it wasn't gray, and everything went back together good.
Yeah, and remember, check your props from time to time, pull them off, look for line, especially that fire line, break your seal pretty easily and allow water in your lower unit. You don't want that, you don't want trouble on the water. Next week, what are we doing?
Crankcase.
Crankcase oil in the Verado. The kickers, we don't have many hours on those, so we're not going to do those, but we'll show you how to change the oil on the Verado. That's it for today. Right, Mike? Now what are we going to do?
See ya.
See ya. He's going to eat another hot dog and spill ketchup.
Yeah, my shit's dried out now.
All right, thanks for watching.